Hey everyone, it's Samson Cunningham from the Better Detroit Youth Movement media team, and we're shooting on location and we're going to create art. So let's create art with LM Kaz.
Hello guys, it's been a while. Hi, I miss you. Okay, so we are not going to do anything different than what I've been doing. Yes, I usually interview some people. Yes, I usually show events where I'm involved in, but today I wanna do a speed painting, and I mean really a speed painting. I'm talking about no more than 15 minutes. Yes, I already primed my board. So if you are used to doing art, you probably know that you usually supposed to put a first layer of color on your canvas for the paint to stick even stronger. Some people prefer gesso. Some people prefer to just use water. I prefer to put paint on it first before I get started, make sure it's completely dry before the fun can start. So thanks for joining in and let's start having some fun. Now, I've made a palette. As you can see, I have black, I have primary red, I have some other sort of red here. I have blue, I have yellow, white, I have a green here. But the reason I did not put brown and other colors because I'm gonna show you how to use what you have. Of course, everyone knows red and black makes brown. So that's what we're gonna do today. Show you a little quick mix up and the other colors that I will need, I am going to make only with the colors on this palette. I will complete a 10-minute painting only with the colors on this palette. I will not dip, I will not dabble, I will not go around what I just said. So that's the goal. I'm doing myself a challenge. Use all the paint on this palette challenge. Don't hashtag that. Okay, so let's get started. Today, we're gonna do a cherry blossom. And we're gonna just start off with black. So my cherry blossom, I want to come kind of like off the corner. So we're gonna just go straight in there. I'm gonna go straight in there. I know it looked like I'm kind of dressed all funky and cool or whatever, but I'm not. This jacket is like 8 years old. I have nothing special going on today. Just want to paint a 10-minute speed painting. And I'm really serious about this. The brush I'm using, if you're interested in knowing, it is a number 6 flat bright. So you can see it's flat. It's a level 2. I do 1s and 2s and 3s, so don't look and say, why she has the fancy brushes, only because I chose to this time. So you think about a tree branch, you know, you have the bark of the tree, and then, you know, you have these little twigs that come off the tree. So that's what we're trying to create. So we can have our cherry blossoms. You see, I'm going in different directions. I'm doing that purposely to give it a little bit more character. I mean, I can, if you watch, I can start from the bottom to top and it'll give it like a stroke effect, but I come back in just to smooth things out for myself so I can know the direction I'm going next. But whatever suits your fancy. So I'm just trying to start my branch off. So now that I use the black, I'm gonna use the red. I'm gonna take the red, see the black, and the red, and I'm just gonna just smear those together. Smear them together. I wanna mix, 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 mix. Don't worry, we can get more red if we need to, but we're trying to make a brown. Okay? If you look at it close enough, it looks burgundy. But when you let the pigments lock in with each other, it'll be brown. See how that red and that black just turned into a brown? So you don't have to go running out to go to Blake to get some brown. There we go, right? So the same branches that we just drew, we're gonna use that brown right on top there. Now you can see it's brightening up in certain spots. You can see the brown. Now don't be, you know, looking like, oh, I'm running out of brown, I need more. Use more black, use more red, and blend it to suit your fancy, okay? Yes, we are in my garage. This is an exclusive event right now, okay? We have brought work home, folks. So, again, I'm trying to make this a 10-minute painting. That's the goal. So if you're timing me, good for you, because I will lose track. The reason I'm showing you guys how to do a speed painting today is because some people need stress relievers. Sometimes people need just something else to do besides their everyday. Let me get on Facebook and scroll and look and see what someone is doing. Okay, for that 10 minutes that you probably were worried about, whatever, you can take that 10 minutes, put your energy into something else, and then create something beautiful. So that's why I wanted just to bring up the speed painting. Now you'll hear it 1,000 times on YouTube. I've heard it on YouTube, that's where I got it from. I seen somebody do a speed painting in like 8 minutes and it was beautiful. So I just want to show you guys that if I can do it, you can do it too. Okay. So my brush is getting a little dry because I was talking. So I'm gonna wet it. Keep water in some sort of cup or anything you can find to keep your water in. Maybe a little soap in it too to keep, you know, you can clean it when you really need to. So I'm gonna clean it all the way so it won't drip. So we're gonna start over. We're gonna keep using this gray. This brown. Now don't worry, you probably can't tell the difference between the brown and the gray, but you will, I promise. So I want to keep using this brown. Now I'm going to get my titanium white. Now this is when you can start seeing some progress. I'm going to put a little water on my brush. So now if you look, I used that white with that brown. Now we have a beautiful highlighted color. It's like a brownish color. Whatever you come up with, if you don't like it, you always can start over. So this is gonna be my highlight for my branches. So I'm gonna start from the bottom again. See that? See how I'm starting from the top of the branch now? It's almost like it's blending in. You see how quick that was? That we just created color and art at the same time, guys? I don't know how many minutes it's been. I'll say about 3.5, give or take. Trust me, I am working on it. We are giving this tree branch some life. But you will see when we're finished, which will be very shortly, how our cherry blossoms come out. So I'm going across, you see all those spaces where you might see those small bubbles or you didn't cover up the paint. Go back over them, highlight it with this, same thing that I'm using. You keep going. And design it the way you want. Now, if you wanna do a couple of curvy branches, you know, you just turn your arm in that direction. If you want something more, I'm going back to the black only to darken up my color that I have. Just, you know, self-serving, as I should say. It serves my purpose, but at the same time, you might want something different. If you want to make your branch just with dots, you know, or certain strokes, or however you want to sway your brush to go, That's totally up to you. You do not have to do what I'm doing. You do not have to do it like me. I'm just giving you some quick ideas just to get your mind off of certain things when you're feeling down and you're bored, you know? Or you just want to make a nice painting for your kitchen or your bathroom. Quick tips. That's all. So we're just about done highlighting the branches. And so now I'm going to just get titanium white. That's it. Just titanium white. We want to just, as I call it, play with the branches. So I want to bring out what we already have. And I'm using the same brush because I don't want to mess up the stroke that I'm working on. Don't worry. You might be like, oh, well, why the edges aren't even? Why aren't they looking alike? What does it matter? You're about to put cherry blossoms on top of them. Now, I only showed you guys how to move it in that direction, but I'm going to change that and make it look more like a realistic feel. You see how I did that? Easy peasy lemon squeezy. There we go. I want to get the white again. Pull out another branch. Now you can give it some definition. Now I'm going to do a little black, little here. Do a little black here. Do a little something there. Just throw it in there. And if you see it's not going in evenly, you go over it. And if need be, always wet your brush. Don't forget, don't be scared to wet this brush. Usually I say we have to wait to get started on the cherry blossoms, but we don't today. Now, can you see a little more definition? I hope you can. I hope this helped. Just a tad bit. Now you step back, you might not look, you can't see it at first, but when you look, now this almost kind of sort of looks like a branch. Does it kind of look like a branch? I don't know, to me, it could. To you, it could. But I'm gonna just sass mine up just a bit. So I'm just gonna put a touch of green, just to give it a little life, right? Not much, just a couple strokes here, a couple strokes there on pieces that you already started on. Uh-oh, accidents happen, right? There we go. Put a little green in there. As y'all say, give it some life. I'm gonna give it just a little life. You see the fluidity of the colors? That's the power of that acrylic, people, and that water. It's one of the best mediums I feel money can buy. Oil paints are very expensive, so don't run trying to get that unless that's something that you want to work on. If not, grab a couple acrylics from, again, like Michael's, Joann's, Hobby Lobby, Five Below. Okay, so I'll put a little green in there. That's just me. Now, let's change this brush quickly because we got some cherry blossoms to make. White has always been my favorite. And this brush right here, this right here, this is a mop brush. Specialty brush. It's really soft, really good bristles. The number two. Check it out. And if you don't like this brush I'm using, you can always get your own brush and do things you want. Now this is an important step on how we do the cherry blossoms. I'm gonna mix two colors, half and half. So I'm literally gonna just smother this side in white, smother the other side in pink. Don't mix, just smother them. So you see half and half. See that? Should be half and half. Now, we're gonna make little buds on here, like small little potential cherry blossoms. Just real small. Small little buds. We're gonna just throw in there somewhere. There we go. Try not to mix. Just splash it there. See, yeah, we're gonna have a couple of them. Right there. So I'm gonna do this, and you see I did that and I have a lot of paint on there. Now if you get that like me, because I got some really thick paint, just smear it, just a bit, just so it can be even. And now you know what it's gonna look like when you put it on the canvas, okay? So now we're gonna make a real cherry blossom. Usually it has, I heard, 5 petals, 6 petals. So we're gonna just you just press on there. We're gonna try that again. Use the paint I have. Maybe do two on that one. Do half and half, half red. I'm sorry, magenta and white. The whole point is to be a speed painting. Am I talking too much, guys? Because, you know, I can be a little chatty. So we're gonna keep going with our cherry blossoms. How's it looking? I hope you guys are following with me. And if not, you can always rewatch this with your stuff and go step by step with me. You saw what I did. You seen how easy it was. I mean, if you're looking closely, I think we have some cherry blossoms. Now, are we finished? No. Has it been 10 minutes? Maybe, but are we almost done? We're close. I do this not just for me, because I do it for me. It's self-serving for me to display art and share what I do with you guys, because there's no point of doing this if you're not giving back. You have to always give back to the arts. You always have to give back to the arts. So if you learn something, show someone else, you know? Don't be a goody-two-shoes and, oh, that's my trick. Oh, that's my technique. We all share techniques. We all share techniques. It's not stealing. It's sharing. And sharing is caring. I don't know about you guys, but I think I have some cherry blossoms. I'm gonna put a bud right there. I'm gonna sit that there. Have you noticed I'm not really putting a whole lot on my brush, but we are creating some cherry blossoms. I don't know if you guys believe me, but I think we're on a roll here. Don't be scared to press on down either. Don't be scared. Do your half and half. Some might be bigger than the other. And guess what? It might even almost kind of look sloppy, but this is just the first step. I'm only taking this time to show you how to apply the cherry blossom. I would have been done by now, but I want to show you guys. I don't want you guys to not know how fun and easy it is to get your stress off by just picking up a brush, getting a couple colors, and having a little fun, right? I am having a ball. I don't know if you can tell. I have grown since I've started doing this show. And I'm just ecstatic. Who doesn't paint and be happy at the same time? Like, what's wrong? So we're just about done with these cherry blossoms. Now, what I'm about to do is very simple, quick detail. I don't know how many minutes that's been. And if you're counting, good for you. This is supposed to be a 10-minute speed painting. I'm pretty sure I'm halfway done. I'm gonna take a little black and just kind of go. Oh, this is a very small detail brush. If you can see, not too big. So we're gonna just put a couple of specks in a couple of them. Real light, not a lot. You really don't want to see the black. We don't want that to take over our flowers. See, when you look closely, it's like they're there, but you really can't see them. It's not taking over. And that's what we don't want. We don't want the black to overpower what we've done. See how simple this is? Some might say, oh, it looks easy for you because you've been doing it. No, not really. It all takes time, patience. Enjoy yourself while you do it. It doesn't have to be a big thing. Just enjoy yourself. Okay, we are just about done. am I just trying to create more and don't really have to? Yeah, I am. Okay, so this is just about done. I'm gonna just do just a couple of designs around the tree. You know, like a couple of, you know, just small designs. I'm gonna change that brush. It's not my favorite. See, don't worry. See, even I get, you know, you try something, you didn't like it. I didn't like how that came out. It's kind of wide. So I'm gonna use something a little bit less round, something more flat with the angle. This is an angle brush. And now watch the difference. See, we all make mistakes. When artists act like they don't have accidents, it's terrible. See that? See the definition now? You see the difference? So we're gonna just keep that going. This to me is giving it personality. Like, it's like the vibrations are bouncing off the flower petals or something. Yes, I'm using black. I know people frown at that. Just giving us just a little definition, and you'll see in a minute. And actually, I'm just about done. I'm just perfecting a little couple of things. I promised 10 minutes. Don't know the time. Someone tell me the time. I want to do a couple of them falling, but I don't know. Maybe I'll do that later. I don't know, I just like doing those little squiggly lines. I'm gonna do it with some pink and black. You see that? This is probably wicked to someone. They probably like, that is so cool. And then some might be like, yeah. You know why that's cool? That's art, that's just what it is. That's just how it goes. Everybody's not gonna like your stuff. Be prepared for that. So at the end of the day, you're doing it to have fun. You're not doing it to impress others. You're doing it for self. It sounds selfish, but you gotta have something for yourself, right? I do this because I like it. Well, just about done, folks. Just wanted to just do a quick, small tutorial. Hopefully that was 10 minutes. I'm not sure. Oh, sorry, got distracted. All right, so my final touches. Just gonna just give it a little bit more. A little bit more white in certain spots, just to kind of just highlight those spots that didn't get a lot of attention, as I say. Okay. During the 10 minutes while you're doing this, if you're looking for perfection, you've already lost the reason why you should do this. You should do this for 10 minutes just to say, let me get my mind off of whatever you got going on. Because guess what, people, at the end of the day, we all have things going on. This is a way for me to get away. I don't have to leave the house and run out and do Lord knows what with my money. Like, I can keep my money in my pocket and have fun here. I didn't want to tell you guys I was done, but I'm done. So I don't know if that was 10 minutes. But I know I have cherry blossoms. I don't know if you know that it doesn't have to be a big deal, but that's a 10-minute speed painting. If you have any questions, if you have any concerns, if you want to have any input, support, my first and last name, LaQuandraWatson.LW@gmail.com. You can always look me up on Facebook, LM Kaz Watson, official page. Or direct Samson Cunningham. you know, check us out on YouTube. We're here. We're trying to get more followers. Follow us, share, repost, and this is in the way. Like, share, repost, and you see what we did, folks. That didn't take any time, now did it, right? Show me your speed painting. Show me the first thing that comes. Paint something, don't even think about it, and see what it comes out to. You know, don't be so into the perfection. Be into having fun and just finding your inner self in color, finding your inner self in creativity. We all have it, so don't limit yourself. Catch you guys later. I have to eat dinner. All right. Catch you later. Peace.